Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about the lasso regression, which is also known as the L1 regularization algorithm in the Python. So here lasso is nothing but the least absolute shrinkage and selection operator. So lasso regression is similar to the Ridge regression, and except here we have to add the some absolute values of the coefficients. So coefficients means already I discussed in previous lecture. So suppose it y is equal to mx plus b. So here m is called the coefficient. So here absolute values of the coefficients means here m1 plus m2 plus like that. So we have to add this kind of absolute values of the coefficients to this regression. So lasso regression can completely eliminate the variables by reducing its coefficients to values to zero. So the new term we added here, that is to ordinary least square OLS, is called the L1 regularization. So lasso regression is a modification of the linear regression. So which means that so Ridge regression and lasso regression, so both are the modifications of the linear regression. So in lasso, the loss function is modified to minimize the complexity of the model by limiting the sum of the absolute values of the model coefficients, which is also known as the L1 norm. So which means that so in lasso, the loss function, which can be, so what do you mean by loss function? So this is the loss function. So here the loss function for the lasso regression can be expressed. So here loss function is equal to ordinary least square plus alpha is multiplied with the sum of the absolute values of the magnitude of the coefficients, which means that so here the lasso we can write like this. So which means that the cost function, so 1 by n sigma I is equal to 1 to n yi minus y hat whole square plus lambda is multiplied with this m whole square. So which means thus, so this is the predicted variable. So here y hi hat is nothing but a, we can write like this, mi xi plus b. So which means that so the loss function mean square error can be write like this, 1 by n sigma I is equal to 1 to n yi minus yi hat whole square plus lambda, here sigma from I is equal to 1 to n mi whole square. So this is the total loss function for this lasso regression. So in this loss functions, this alpha is called the penalty parameter. So this alpha value we have to choose manually. So whenever this alpha value is zero, so the lasso regression produce the same coefficients as the linear regression. So what is the linear regression? So linear regression is nothing but the 1 by n sigma I is equal to 1 to n yi minus yi hat whole square. So whenever this alpha value is zero, so this total this value will be becomes zero. So which means whenever alpha is equal to zero, so the lasso regression it becomes the linear regression. Whenever this alpha value is very very large, so at that time the all coefficients means m1, m2 and m3, so these are going to be zero. So this is the lasso regression. So now we are going to the practical section. So here I'm importing the libraries, basic libraries, pandas, numpy, matplotlib, c1. So I'm taking the same data set which I was explained in previous lecture, that is the Boston housing. So this is the head part, and this is the statistical information of this data set. So data set shape is the 506 observations and 14 columns. There is no null values. So I can divide my data set into independent variable and dependent variable. So then I divide my data set into train test split, which means that my training data set is about 80% and 20% is allocated for the testing data. So the lasso regression penalizes the model, so based on the sum of the magnitude of the coefficients. So the regressionization term is given by, so what is mean by regularization, which means that so lambda is multiplied with the sum of the coefficients of the sum of the magnitude of the coefficients. So here lambda is called the shrinking factor. So here I'm inputting the lasso, and here I'm taking the alpha value 0.5. so you can take the alpha value, so you can take the alpha value from 0 to any positive integer. So here I'm taking the alpha value 0.5. So now let's check the how our model is going to be fit on the test data. So I'm check the R2 score. So I got the 0.6148. when I check on the train score, so I got the train score 0.7436, which means whenever alpha value is 0.5, so I got this kind of results. Whenever you can here you can choose the any value between 0 to any positive integer. Suppose I'm taking alpha value 1, so again the results are going to change. So here I'm assigning the alpha value, so in place of 1 I'm taking the value 10. So again I'm executing, so results are going to change. So if it is intercept, so this is the intercept value and this is the coefficients, and this is the coefficient values corresponding to these input values. Whenever I mean changes my alpha value, so here the sum of the coefficients are going to 0, which means that alpha value, so this is the coefficients, these coefficients are be 0, which means this features, this feature, this feature, and this features has to be eliminated. Why? Because these coefficients are be 0, so these two coefficients also be 0, and this coefficient also be 0. So only what is the this coefficient will be 0. So the what are the coefficients are 0, those corresponding features has to be eliminated from this data set, which means that we can select the best features for predicting the target variable. So that's why this lasso regression we can also call the feature selection technique. So here I plotting the, so whenever, see here in this graph, so this is the 0, from here to here, from 0 to downwards it is the negative coefficient values, from 0 to up it is the positive coefficients. So here what is the values are going to be 0, so these values are all 0 values, which means the coefficients of these features are 0 0, and this is also be 0, so this is also be 0, which means that this is the feature x1 and x3, this is x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, x7, x8, x9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So among 13 independent features, only this feature 2, 3, 4, 5, these 5 features we are going to select for the predicting the target variable. So rest of the features are coefficients are 0, that's why we have to remove this input features. So x1, x3, x4, x5, x6, x8, x9 and x11. So these are the features we are going to eliminate. So whenever if you suppose to change this value, In place of 10, I am taking the value 1. So the values are going to change. See, coefficients are going to change. So here only some of the coefficients are be 0. Only these three coefficients are 0. So others are be values are existed. So which means that, so these coefficients are only 0. Which means the three coefficients are only 0. So rest of the coefficients we have to consider for predicting the target variable. So that's why in regression kind of algorithms, lasso regression is very very important for feature selection techniques. So here what I'm doing, so here I don't know which alpha value I supposed to choose. So that's why I choosing these some range of values. So I'm taking the alpha value 0.1, 0.001, 0.05. 0.05, and I will plot this graph. In this graph here, so in this graph this is the x value. On x axis I am taking the alpha values, and on y axis I am taking the accuracy scores. So accuracy scores are train score and test score. So here this is the train score and this is the test score. So whenever alpha value is 0.101, so this is the train score and this is the test score, and the difference between train score and test score is like this. So it depends upon the train score, test score is depends upon the totally alpha value. Whenever alpha value is, so what kind of ranges you supposed to provide here, so according to that you will get this train score and test score. Suppose let me check, I will give some other values. Here I am passing the alpha values range from 1 to 5, otherwise inference range from 1 to 15. So if you see alpha value it 1, this is the results you got. So whenever alpha value is going to increase, so the train score and test score are be decreasing. So here alpha value is going to increasing, so the train score is also be decreasing and this is test score also be decreasing. So which means whenever alpha value is going to increasing, so this accuracy is train score and test score going to be decrease. If you see, if you pass this values like 0.1, so in this graph, in this diagram, in this output, so whenever alpha value is 0.1, so this input x1, x2, x3 up to x13, so this is the input value like this. Whenever alpha value is 0.5, this is the m1 value. So this is the x1 means this is the m1 and this is the m2 and this is, sorry, so this is the m1, this is m2, m3, like that. So whenever alpha value is 0.10, so this is the x1, this is m1, this is x2, this is m2. Whenever alpha value is 0.5, this is the result you got. So these are the coefficient values. So whenever alpha is value going to increasing, see the results are going to change. So most of the coefficients are be 0. So this is the coefficient value 0. So compared to alpha value 0.01, so the alpha value 10 is going to 0, which means that whenever alpha value is going to increasing, so the coefficients are be, coefficients are going to be towards 0, which means about to 0. So this is the matrix, other matrix like mean absolute error, mean square error and root mean square error. Suppose in this code here I'm taking the some values like alpha value 0.01, 0.001, 1, 3, 5, like that. So you can take alpha value, any value from 0 to any positive integer. So I'm taking some of the alpha values. So if I execute this code, so whenever alpha value 0.01, so this is my train score and this is my R2 score, This is mean absolute error, mean square error, root mean square error. So here you can clearly observe that whenever going to change the alpha values, the correspondingly the results are going to be changed. But you have to observe one thing. Here alpha value is the hyperparameter value. So this is the manually we have to select this value. This value between 0 to any positive integer. So lasso can be used when we have more number of features. Suppose in our data set more number of features are there. For example, 100 columns, 200 columns, 500 columns. So at that time, so this lasso algorithm can automatically do the feature selection. But what is the problem with this lasso? When we have correlated features, so it retains only one feature. For example, there is a x1, x2. These are the two features. So these two features are be correlated. So if two features are be correlated, so here we have to choose any one of the feature, either x1 or x2. So if you choose x2, you have to drop the x1. Why? Because what are the information is provided by the x1 feature, the same information also provided by the x2 feature. That's why we have to choose any one of the feature and drop the other feature. So if you drop the other feature, there is a drawback that we have to lose this some kind of information. So we have to lose this some kind of information. That's why whenever we have correlated features, so only one variable it has to be set to 0, another variable it has to be pick up. So this will leads to the sum of the, so if you pick up this one variable and drop the other variable, so there is a loss of information. And automatically you will get the less accuracy of your model. If we have very few features of the data, so and the score is very poor for the both training and testing score. If you have very, very few features, means number of features are very less, so at that time you will get the train score and test score very low. So at that time the model will be underfitting. So whenever it is going to underfitting, whenever we have the very few number of the features, at that time you will get the lesser training score and lesser test score, which means that you are getting the low training score, low test score. At that time model is going to be underfitting. Suppose if we have large number of features, for example 100 features, 500 features, so at that time, so the test score is be poor, so train score is be high and the test score is be poor. So at that time then the, so this is the situation is called the overfitting. So this is the situation we used to call overfitting. If you take very few data, underfitting may happen. If you take more features, overfitting may happen. So lasso regression, it is the best algorithm can choose the features, best features for predicting the target variable. So this is the concept of the lasso regression. I hope you understand this concept. If you have any kind of doubts and please make it in comment section. Thank you.